This is Melissa.
I don't look so happy right now. It's like 4:59 in the evening. I just had my second dose of gel.
And hopefully it does something.
The 30 minutes that you had to lay there hurt like a bitch, but I'm feeling much better.
Hopefully the second dose does something, because the first one didn't.
The first one felt like lighter fluid and matches inside of me, but I'm not feeling that effect this time around, so I'm like thanking the Lord for that one, but I definitely am getting contractions, but mostly cramps. And I'm getting one now. I'm not dealing very well with the cramp part. The contractions I can handle, but the cramps don't go away.
So we're here for the evening at the hospital. Gonna watch some movies.
Yeah, we're gonna
wait until quarter after 10.
We're waiting to see what I got for supper. It was probably not very appetizing.
Chances are I'll be going on a food run.
We'll see.
Anything else you want to say right now?
No. I'm nervous, but I've calmed down a lot since this morning. My heart nearly isn't as crazy as it was this morning.
So, this is the update for now.
The minimal induction update. Yeah. I was hoping, you know,
Not much going on, but...
rocking it out at 5-6 centimeters, but that's not happening.
But it's alright.
Do I still look pretty?
You look beautiful.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll see how you are later on.
Hopefully a lot better.
Hopefully. See you guys later.
So, there's been a slight change in plans. I had a uterus transplant. Now Matthew's gonna have a baby.
Decided I'd deliver the baby since I've got a higher pain tolerance.
Oh, God. I'm just, like, chilling out in the chair. You can see my feet there. Just chilling out with my Burger King. And Matthew's gonna have the baby for me. So it is 6:30 pretty much. The uterus transplant took place a few minutes ago. It was clearly successful, judging by his baby bump.
Do I look sexy pregnant?
Yeah, you look really hot pregnant. There's Mom. Show your face. Eating her giant chocolate chip cookie. Oh my gosh. Yep.
Welcome to the second floor.
Second floor. In case...
No wonder the child doesn't want to come out.
In case, oh my god. In case nobody knows the second floor is where they have the psych patients.
This is what happens in labor and delivery while we're waiting for baby. Foolishness.
Alright, talk to you guys soon. Maybe in the next update I'll film Matthew pushing her out. We'll see. Okay, bye.
This is Melissa. Her second day at the hospital.
It's been 24 hours now.
It's been 24 hours now.
Hours.
She's having some pains. 3 doses of the gel. Still waiting for the doctor to come in because it's super busy here. Lots of babies being born.
I have morphine shakes. I feel like a drug addict.
She got the morphine and the Gravol last night.
Gravol wasn't cutting it, so they had to give me morphine so I could sleep, and I'm glad that I came in because I actually slept. But I woke up really, really sick feeling or nauseous at 5 a.m. and they gave me more Gravol, and I'm still working on that dose. Still feeling okay, but I'm having some nausea. A lot of nausea. And a lot of intense
hopefully baby comes today.
So it's
9:26.
26 in the morning. On July 18th.
This is a labor. So baby, when you're watching this video when you're older, appreciate your mother. I'll kick your butt.
Sitting up than laying down, that's for sure. I can manage a lot better. It's that 30 minutes after the gel, I can't deal with it. You have to lay there still while it absorbs. And the contractions are coming every, what, 2 to 3 minutes, she said?
Every 2 to 3 minutes, she said it.
Fingers crossed for progression. Oh Lord, I'll go postal if not.
Oh Lord, hopefully all this did something. Just give us a centimeter or two.
I've been having contractions like this since 9:30 last night, so 12 hours out. Hopefully.
And if it didn't do anything, Melissa's going postal.
I'm gonna get back in that lovely jacuzzi tub. Mm-hmm. That has my name written all over it. That was so relaxing last night. I got my second dose of gel at 10:30, and I was in the tub by 11 and didn't get out until 11:45.
That was your third dose.
Oh yeah, my third dose. I'm losing it, see?
We've been here a while, it's okay. It's nothing easy about this.
Nope, that's for sure. Nope. Alright. We'll talk the next update. I don't know how calm or how relaxed I will be. I think once I get this dose, that's it. Because after this dose, I have a feeling if it doesn't work, they're just going to go ahead and break my water. And then I'll be begging then for an epidural. I know I will. I've done this good to go, just morphine. And I've had Tylenol 3 early on, but I don't know how women do this naturally. You guys are freaking amazing that you do, like, 2 big thumbs up, because I can't. Trying, though, my goal is to make it to at least 6 centimeters before I get an epidural. Hopefully we can make it there, but if not, I don't care. So we'll talk later.
See you guys.
What is this? What time is
it? 10:11.
This is the not so pretty part of labor for me. It's been really, really hard. I'm in a lot of pain. Throwing up like crazy.
Horrible, horrible.
So we were supposed to have a C-section tomorrow morning around 10 o'clock. We're gonna be parents a little 12 hours earlier than that, so we're going in about 1:45 to meet our baby. And I'm so excited. I'm in so much pain.
It's been really, really hard on Melissa.
I have never thrown up so much in my entire life. And they gave me like morphine, Gravol, Zofran. I'm hooked up to Zofran now, and it went in 15 minutes ago, and I'm still puking my guts up. And I haven't eaten today, so it's throwing up from pain. So seven and a half years is boiling down to 45 minutes. this is completely, completely worth it all. And I'm really excited. Alright.
Ellianna Grace.
Perfect little baby girl.
Aren't you something to admire? Cause you're shining something like a mirror, and I can't help but notice you reflect in this heart of mine. If you ever feel alone and the glare makes me hard to find, just know that I'm always parallel on the other side. Cause with your hand in my hand and a pocket full of soap, I can say there's no place we couldn't go. Just put your hand on the past, I'll be trying to pull you through. You just gotta be strong. I don't wanna lose you now. I'm looking right at the other half of me. The biggest scene that's set in my heart is a space, and now you're home. Show me how to fight for now. And I tell you, baby, it was easy coming back into you once I figured it out. You were right here all alone. It's like you're my mirror. My mirror staring back at me. I couldn't get any bigger with anyone else beside me. And now it's clear as this promise that we're making two reflections into one. Cause it's like you're my mirror.
And original, cause it doesn't seem really as simple. And I can't help but stare, cause I see true summer in your eyes. Ooh, I can't ever change without you. You reflect me, I love that about you. And if I could, I would look at us all the time. With your hand in my hand and a pocket full of soap, I can tell you there's no place we couldn't go. Just put your head on the past, I'll be trying to put.